it is. Take a good look at this booby trap. It could be made for you. This is a hefty charge, and that fuse is an electrochemical delay fuse, an EKHV fuse, set to go off in 10 days. And here, in addition, is a simple detonator cut into the wiring of the house, so that any attempt to use the electricity before 10 days will destroy this room and everyone in it. The complicated and the simple in one deadly package. In a few days, an enemy will be in this room. What happens after that depends upon what the new occupants will do or not do. A very thorough job. There will be no telltale marks on the floorboards. What's this? A book booby trap. That's an old gag, but don't laugh. It has worked before, and there's always a first time for someone. They've booby trapped this place because they're withdrawing, and they need to gain time. If you become a casualty here, they gain time. If you spend a day or two to make this room safe, they gain time. In booby trapping, win, lose, or draw, the booby trapper gains time. Just be sure he doesn't get you as a dividend. That pistol is for free, a psychological trick. If you pick it up after checking it, you'll assume everything else in the room must be safe. They've done a fine job. Now let's see what their satellite friends can do. It's winter. The place? North Korea. Here, the bare necessities for life are scarce. Shelter, water, firewood. But here is some firewood. And some more wood. This firewood is for you. And there you have it. With the most simple equipment, in a land devastated by war, they can still plant a very effective booby trap. The price of one piece of dry wood can come very high. In hasty withdrawals, Soviet and satellite troops will use booby trapping to gain distance as well as time. Again, just be sure it's not at your expense. Watch this carefully, for this is not the sort of thing you would do. But they will do it frequently and without the slightest hesitation. This officer, when alive, was useful. Dead, he will still be of use. The double bluff. If you're suspicious of the body on the road, you'll move it with a rope, and you'll do it from behind the boulder. And that is exactly what they hope you'll try. A body, a briefcase, a grenade. A boulder in a mine. A simple formula for quick and certain death. The booby trapping of anti-tank mines is a common practice of the Soviets and their satellites. Frequently, the cheapest and simplest devices are used. This wood anti-lifting device, for instance, can be fabricated in the field with almost any available box wood. The lid is held down, keeping the springs compressed. Next, the anti-tank mine is positioned over the device. Should anyone find this mine and try to pick it up, the lid of the wood anti-lifting device will spring up, pulling the pin on the MUV fuse, and both device and mine will be detonated. Simple, cheap, and fatal. The life of the individual soldier is highly valued in the armies of the free world. In contrast, Soviet and satellite troops are indifferent to the consequences of indiscriminate booby trapping. They will booby trap anything. Here had a nice setup, but they've cleared out. They must have left in a hurry. A place like this could be absolutely safe, or it could be deadly. One thing sure, it will look safe. In booby trapping, an enemy will always take advantage of your basic human traits. Be suspicious. Give him credit for knowing something about human nature. He knows about your curiosity. What's in that bottle? Vodka? What's inside that? Some stuff they've looted from civilians? He understands your boredom and need for variety. It's been a long time since you heard any music. He also appreciates your love for possessions and souvenirs. He's only too happy to provide you with junk you'd like to take home.